Namaste, honorable dignitaries and friends and colleagues. It indeed is a privilege to be here speaking to you all. And while the eminent speakers have been very, very emphatic about the blue economy as a whole, I stand before you to champion one of the eight verticals which somehow or the other is the most glamorous and most nascent, because cruise tourism and exploiting the potential is just being tapped. And I think because of that, the opportunity expanse there is phenomenal. Under the aegis of Honorable Gadkari ji, a cruise tourism committee has been formed, which primarily has three major objectives. One is to ensure that more and more cruise liners start visiting Indian shores, and the cruise don't just touch Mumbai or one or two ports, but make the entire coastal area a tourism hub. The second is a more important one, which I believe, is to ensure that all the cruise passengers who come have a very beautiful experience in the cities that they visit, because they are our ambassadors when they go back. And the third is to, in a three-year roadmap, exploit the big potential of Mumbai, Alibag, Goa, to develop it like a platinum corridor, a platinum triangle, for the rich and famous to have the marinas and jetties ecosystem built for a tourism experience which by and far has surprisingly left India untouched. All the speakers before me have talked about the coastline that is available to us and how we have been maritime seafarers. And yet, this aspect of enjoying the oceans as a tourism pastime has somehow just not been tapped. A cruise tourism initiative was taken up at the central government level, and a cruise tourism committee formed. A task force was formed in November 2015, co-chaired by Secretary Shipping and the Secretary Tourism, to steer at the highest level jointly with all stakeholders, the ports, immigrations, tourism board, port, health, customs, taxation bodies, etc. They then appointed the internationally renowned consultants, Bermelo Ajmal and partners, to prepare a roadmap and action plan for India's cruise tourism. The report was tabled sometime around December 2017. And thereafter, five cruise ports have been identified for immediate upgrading facilities: Mumbai, Goa, Mangalore, Kochi, and Chennai. Day after tomorrow, we have a very big session on the potential of cruise tourism and tourism as a whole on the blue economy. So I'm not going to go into the micros at this platform. But I just want to table one small fact to all of you so that you'll understand how invigorated the tourism industry is to see the potential growth under the leadership of Gadkari ji. While about 36 cruise liners visited India, in Mumbai, in 2017-18, 2019-20 is going to see 255 cruise liners visit Mumbai's port. Now that is a quantum jump. The figure will just exponentially increase. We were proud to take a small delegation to Dubai last December and start etching what will shape up to be a very big handshake between Mumbai and Dubai to develop a cruise corridor. A lot of the big daddies of the shipping world who come up to Dubai, and Dubai has a phenomenal amount of infrastructure. We have to map up that. I was talking to Dhawan Saab in the morning about it. Do not really make tracks into the Indian coastline. So Dubai is very keen to exploit that, because on the return traffic, they see a tremendous amount of potentials of Indian tourists coming. The Indian counterparts, and especially at the Mumbai port, we see a lot of potential because the ships which are coming to Dubai can be attracted to Mumbai, keeping in mind the huge ramp up of infrastructure which the Mumbai port is now doing to accommodate them. There are a lot of initiatives which are being taken, which the next session where we are having a presentation on the port development is going to be given. But a lot of micro detailing is going into it, and I can represent the port development authorities only from the tourism perspective. So a lot of micro detailing is being given. A task force has been set up to actually go and include even BMC, the traffic police of Mumbai, the various stakeholders at Mumbai First, to ensure that the tourists who disembark at Mumbai port are given a very, very good visit of the city. We are getting our feet dirty, actually, standing on the shop floor and being counted to actually rebuild 4 zones with toilets and sanitized areas where traffic police and tourism police will be available to the tourists who disembark. Certain things which were not known or not imagined earlier, but simple things which can be delivered are being implemented. For example, catamaran services from directly within the port for Elephanta Caves, helicopter services, because the cruise passengers have a very limited time. They probably dock in for one night or one morning and leave the night. So in within one small span, they want to see the city. So all these initiatives seem very easy, but in a city like Mumbai, with multiple nodal officer coordination required, it becomes sometimes little challenging. I'm being politically correct when I say little challenging. But yes, the work is going on where, thanks to Nitin Gadkari ji, and I'm not saying this because I'm standing on this platform and want to be heard to be praising him, but I'll give you a yardstick of what Gadkari ji has brought to the table. When he asked me that, why is the tourism department not backing our initiatives? I said, sir, very honestly, most of the tourism people are just hearing it from the press. They have not really engaged with the authorities who are implementing these projects. He said, great, let's have a session to interact with them. I said, we could do that. And we plan to have a small leaders of the industry engagement with Honorable Minister in the port conference room. The kind of response we got from the travel industry was mind-blowing. We had to shift the conference from the conference room to the Trident, and about 300 people, doyens of the industry, were all present, including the film industry, who want to shoot in our ports. So that is the kind of galvanizing effect we've had. Immediately thereafter, INCLA was formed, the Indian Cruise Liners Association, which has also been a very big stepping stone for the big daddies of the cruise world to now look at India in a different perspective, because now there is an association which is looking into their demands and their problems with customs and immigration formalities, etc., and somebody who is representing and trying to map out the problems and take it up at government level, at the topmost level. So at the Cruise Tourism Committee, while the challenges to us are many, we see this as a golden era in the next 3 years, where the only trajectory is upward. Thank you very much for the platform.